companies need to innovate faster and faster, and they need to adapt digitally to the customer demand to stay really competitive. And data and cloud, they are two important foundations to digitally transform. So what are common hurdles and how can enterprises speed up? Moti Bararaf, he is the Chief Revenue Officer at Equalum, and he is here to share his experience on how organizations successfully transform with the help of data and with the help of cloud. Welcome, Moti.
Thank you, Ronald. Glad to be here.
Yeah, glad to have you. So to stay competitive, organizations need to adapt and they need to innovate faster, as I mentioned in the introduction. But we see successful, but we see also companies that have troubles in getting there. Can you share any insights on successful strategies that companies use to modernize?
In two words, data infrastructure. So if you look at the motivation of some of those enterprises moving to the cloud, it's about getting access in real time to their data. It's being able to drive performance and speed of innovation, accommodate new business model, and be flexible while streamlining their operational systems, optimizing their data architecture, and doing all of that with a lower TCO. So before you move into the cloud, you need to ask yourself, do you have the right infrastructure to allow you for an end-to-end data integration? Are you going to be locked into one cloud? Are you looking at a multi-cloud strategy? Is it a hybrid by having some prem data and cloud data? What are you going to do with your existing batch processes and the new streaming processes that you're adding? Where are you going to process the data or enrich the data? Is it going to be done on-prem? Is it going to be done on the cloud? Is it an ETL? Is it an ELT? Is it a combination, most likely, of both? So finding a reliable and an end-to-end solution platform that would allow you to quickly adapt to the ever-going changes. We're seeing just in the last year so many changes happening with the introduction of Delta Lakes and other. Think of what would be the situation a year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now. You want to be able to build and have that reliability end to end, while hopefully not being locked into one cloud and having that flexibility to move around clouds.
And if we look to these success stories, what kind of trends or similar approaches do you see with these companies? Are there any key components that are the foundation of a future-proof approach?
Yeah, that's a great one. So, you know, when you look at what is some of the motivations, you know, customers are saying or trying to say goodbye to outdated and increasingly insufficient legacy infrastructures. They're trying to overcome compute power limitations, overloaded systems, and a lot of legacy hardware and software that it's not operating to the need of today's business and today's data requirements. So when you look at a solution, you want to look at agility, and that is the ability to quickly with hopefully a UI and not a code base, move into new data pipelines, new offerings, if you will. You want to have reliability. You want to know that if things break, and things will break, that your solution can overcome that and can be can allow you that reliability end to end. You want to look at scalability. That scalability is all the way from making more with the same compute power. It's about being ready to ingest the amount of data that the organization that we're seeing coming in the organization and the growth trajectory. And also you want to be scalable in that multi-cloud approach and not be locked in into a single cloud. So that end-to-end system reliability and scalability is key when you're looking to build those future-proof solutions.
And you were talking about legacy systems. You were talking about the challenges with sometimes compute power. What are typical obstacles you have seen for at large enterprise specifically that manage this transformation to the cloud? Are there specific ones you want to address?
All right, so when we look at some of the common data ingestion scenarios in the cloud, we're looking at three mainly. One is the zero downtime of moving from on-prem to the cloud. The second is enabling real-time cloud analytics. And the third is enabling that cloud BI and reporting. So when you look at the technical challenges, first one comes to mind is migrating data from one technology to another. When you're trying to do that, there's a whole slew of technical challenges that you need to address, anywhere from data type conversion to syntax to drivers. And you want to do that, obviously, in the seamless, quickest, and frictionless manner possible. The second piece is continuous non-intrusive data acquisition. So how are you able to collect the data from all these various operational systems while being as little disruptive as possible to their day-to-day operations? And then the third one, and that's a big one, is once you've built those pipelines and you have hundreds, thousands and of flows and processes all running in the same time continuously, how do you manage them? How do you make sure that when things break, and things will break, either on the sources, either somewhere in between, on the network side, there will be failures. How do you recover? How do you get notifications? How do you monitor the situations? And how do you bring it to self-healing as quickly as possible? So the next big technical, or the last one that I want to address as far as the technical aspect, is the multiple tools, right? The realities of today is that you've got multiple tools running in various organizations. It could be a result of do-it-yourself in-house projects. It could be a result of having legacy tools over time that have been added on top of each other. It could be through acquisitions of new companies, and with them some new tools. So when you look at the economics of that and the challenges of that, you want to be able to consolidate that and migrate that over time. You don't want to do it all at once. You don't want to boil the ocean. And what we've seen to work is a project-based approach where you select one or two projects that are kind of spearheading that initiative within the organization. And then once they're successful, you move the rest. And then lastly, the realities of beyond the technology, there's the realities of organizational challenges. And that is the fact that organizations that spend millions and millions in building those projects and building those solutions, and it cannot happen all at once. You don't want to boil the ocean. You want to take a crawl, walk approach, and you want to be aware that there are teams that are focusing on single solutions, and now they're coming together. So the key point here is that with all of those challenges, you want to be looking at an end-to-end data integration solution that would allow you to facilitate the move to the cloud. You want it to be with less cost, you want it in less time, and you want to have a reliable end-to-end solution at the end of the day.
I think, yeah, some great tips for having zero downtime during your migration, having real-time analytics, and on the other hand, having access to everybody in the enterprise. Moti, thanks a lot for sharing your insights. And for the audience, thank you for watching, and we're looking forward to seeing you next time.